हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज रियल एनालिसिस लेक्चर बीएससी सेकंड ईयर। सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज मीन बाय डेडकाइट कैंटर एक्सियोम, रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ अ रियल नंबर ऑन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन, नेबरहुड ऑफ अ पॉइंट, डिलीटेड नेबरहुड एंड सम इलस्ट्रेशंस। इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू सम एग्जांपल्स। नाउ फर्स्ट एग्जांपल अ नॉन एम्प्टी फाइनाइट सेट, अ नॉन एम्प्टी फाइनाइट सेट इज नॉट इन नेबरहुड ऑफ एनी ऑफ इट्स पॉइंट्स, एनी ऑफ इट्स पॉइंट्स। So consider a finite set S, a1, a2, ... This is a finite set and it contains n elements. So we have to show that S is not a neighborhood of any of its points. That is, a non-empty finite set is not a neighborhood of any of its points. So first note that the definition of a neighborhood, which says that n is said to be neighborhood of a point A if there exists a open interval I containing A and contained in n. Containing A and contained in n. There must exist some open interval I containing A and contained in n. So open interval necessarily has infinite number of elements. Every open interval has infinite number of elements. So open interval साठी किती elements लागतात? Infinite number of elements लागतात. आणि आपल्याला set दिलेला कोणता आहे? Finite set आहे. मग तिथं ओपन इंटरवल एक्झिस्ट होणार का? होणारच नाही. सो तिथं एखादी ओपन इंटरवल एक्झिस्ट होत नाही. देअरफोर अ नॉन एम्प्टी फायनाईट सेट इज नॉट अ नेबरहुड ऑफ एनी ऑफ इट्स पॉइंट्स, बिकॉज देअर डज नॉट एक्झिस्ट एनी ओपन इंटरवल. Therefore, non-empty finite set is not a neighborhood of any of its points. So this is the example first. Now, example second. A superset of a neighborhood of a point A is also a neighborhood of a point A. Superset of a neighborhood of a point A is also a neighborhood of a point A. We know that if A is a subset of B, then we read, there are so many methods to read this. A is a subset of B, B contains A, B is a superset of A, A is contained in B. So there are so many methods to read this. So if A is a subset of B, then we call B is a superset of A. B is superset of A. B is a superset of A. Now see example number 2. A superset of a neighborhood of a point A is also a neighborhood of a point A. Now consider if A belongs to I is contained in N. If N is a neighborhood of a point A and it is contained in M, that is M is a superset of N. then from this we can write A belongs to I, which is contained in M. So this is the definition of neighborhood of a point. So A belongs to I and I is contained in M. This shows that M is a neighborhood of a point A. This implies M is neighborhood of a point A. From this we can directly say that a superset of a neighborhood of a point A is also a neighborhood of a point A. Now example number 3. Union finite or arbitrary. Finite or arbitrary. Union finite or arbitrary of neighborhood of a point A is also a neighborhood of a point A. If the given point is A, and suppose that there are a finite number of neighborhoods of a point A, say n1, n2, n3, .. So these are the finite number of neighborhoods of a point A. If we unite them, if we do union of these finite number of neighborhoods, then it is also a neighborhood of the point A. Suppose n1, n2, .. These are the n neighborhoods of a point A. Then their union I running from 1 to n, ni, is also a neighborhood of a point A. Is also a neighborhood of a point A. This is the finite union. Now if we large it to infinite, then it is also neighborhood of a point A. Now n1, n2, n3, ...... infinite number of neighborhoods of a point A, then this example shows that I running from 1 to infinity ni is also neighborhood of a point A, is also neighborhood of a point A. So example 3 says that union that is finite or arbitrary of a neighborhood of a point A is also a neighborhood of a point A. Now example number 4. Example number 3 is about union. Now example number 4 is about intersection. If M and N are neighborhoods of a point X, then prove that M intersection N is also a neighborhood of a point X. If M and N are neighborhoods of a point X, then M intersection N is also a neighborhood of a point X. Now I am going to prove this. Now proof. Given that M and N are neighborhoods of a point X. If M is a neighborhood of a point X, then there exist open interval I1 such that X belongs to X minus delta 1, X plus delta 1, which is contained in M. So this is I1. Now, also given that N is a neighborhood of a point X. From this, there exists open interval I2 such that X belongs to X minus delta 2, X plus delta 2, which is contained in M. Because given that M is a neighborhood of a point X. Now choose delta to be minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. Now observe that if X is a given point, this is first neighborhood, this is second neighborhood, X minus delta 1, X plus delta 1, X plus delta 2, X plus delta 1. So this is the two neighborhoods of a point X. This is a first interval I1. This is I1 and this is our second open interval I2. So these are the two open intervals containing X. Now choose delta to be minimum of delta 1 and delta 2. So X belongs to X minus delta, X plus delta, which is contained in M. X belongs to X minus delta, X plus delta, which is contained in N. So there exists an open interval containing X and contained in both M and N. This implies that X belongs to X minus delta, X plus delta, which is contained in M intersection N. So there exists an open interval X minus delta to X plus delta, which is totally contained in M intersection N. Therefore, from the definition of neighborhood of a point, M intersection N is a neighborhood of a point X. This implies that M intersection N is neighborhood of a point X. So this is the proof. So example number one, what was that? A non-empty finite set is not a neighborhood of any of its points, because open interval necessarily contains infinite number of points. So infinite set, there does not exist any interval, therefore it is not a neighborhood of any of its points. Now second, superset of a neighborhood of a point X is also a neighborhood of a point X. So superset, so if M is a neighborhood of a point X, so there exists an open interval I containing X and contained in M. Now N is a superset of M, therefore we can write X belongs to I, which is contained in N. So N is also neighborhood of a point X. Now union, either finite or arbitrary, union of a neighborhood of a point X is also a neighborhood of a point X. Now if M and N are neighborhoods of a point X, then their intersection is also neighborhood of a point X. Now आजचं लेक्चर आपण इथंच कन्क्लूड करूया. नेक्स्ट कन्सेप्ट इन नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ. थँक्यू.